stick around to the end of this video where I share my opinion on whether designers should code. So dev mode in Figma was announced last June and it was available as a free beta up until this January, and then it's become a paid feature. And when it changed over to a paid feature, there was a lot of controversy about it, but I really like it. And this is why. I think that Figma's dev mode will help reduce the gap between design and implementation. I think this is better illustrated with an example. So this is a really simple app designed to help you make a loaf of bread. I was finding that when I was baking bread, I would constantly be flicking between a recipe and then the timer app on my phone. And I thought, wouldn't it be cool to just have this all in one page, a really beautifully designed recipe to follow with everything you need up at the top. And then built into this page are hyperlinks that open up a floating timer widget. So you don't have to change app, it's all there in one place. The problem with designing something like this in Figma, especially when it's a solo project, is that in Figma, it becomes so easy to just add on more features. While I was designing these screens, I was thinking, wouldn't it be great to be able to customize the variables and say, maybe I want a slightly smaller loaf or I want to do two loaves. And one of the problems with using design tools is that it's just so easy and actually quite fun to design all of these options. But it's way easier to do this in Figma than it is to then take it into code and make it as a developer. When it comes to translating things into code, there's just so much more complexity involved in every step. So the way to counter this is to hand over your designs as early and as often as possible. I think developer handover is one of those things that everyone likes to have an opinion about, but I think everyone would agree that as early and as often as possible is the way to do it. There's no point sitting in a silo and designing something for 6 months and then never speaking to a developer, because by then you'll have loads of bells and whistles and you won't know what's feasible and you won't hit any of your timelines. So this is why I think dev mode is good. It encourages us as designers to think about the journey a developer has when they look at our designs. Instead of relying on that inspect panel and just thinking, hey, developers will find everything they need, it becomes a lot more intentional. So in dev mode, you can add annotations, you can add measurements. I particularly love annotations because you can highlight certain properties. So if you've got all your colors or your border radiuses defined as variables and you're changing the usual way of doing something, you can just pull out an annotation and say, hey Liam, the border radius on this card component has changed to small, and I think we should do that on all card components going forward. And then it becomes more of a two-way dialogue. It's not just you designing in isolation, it's more of a conversation with your developer. And yeah, I think that's why I really like dev mode. It changes developer handoff from being, hey, let's take this design and throw it over the garden fence and not think about it anymore, into more of a conversation. It's something more intentional. So yeah, I appreciate it launched with some controversy, but I think overall it is a good thing for the design space. This also brings me to the next thing I want to talk about, which is, should designers code? Now this question's become a bit of a meme in some group chats I'm in, but I just want to quickly share my opinion, which is that designers should have some familiarity with code. Now I know that's a bit of a cop-out answer, so I'm going to make it a bit more concrete. I think designers should specifically be able to do these five things. Firstly, I think all designers should understand the box model. They should know the difference between margins and padding and where the content sits. Even if you're not designing for web and you're designing for native devices, the box model is so important to understand. And especially with auto layout, it's basically like learning how to use auto layout in Figma anyway. So you should know what the box model is. Secondly, I think all designers should have a basic understanding of how developer tools work in browsers. So if you right click on any web page and go to inspect element, you can see all of the code of that website and you can see CSS properties on the right or maybe below. And you can just quickly change stuff. You can play around with hex codes, change the fills of things, add shadows, try out different ways of doing layouts. And I think just experimenting with this is such a good way of understanding how your designs will eventually be built. Often when a client or a stakeholder has asked me for a different version of something, instead of taking it into Figma and recreating it, I've just gone into Inspect Element and toyed around with some properties. So it's really useful for experimenting as well. Thirdly is knowing how a code base is structured. And I mean this at a really high level. I think if you've got a React app or a Vue app, you should know where all your front-end components live, where all your styles live. I think knowing this will just help you be a bit more independent. Often, I like to ask to be added to a GitHub project so that I can clone it to my machine. And even though I'm not pushing anything to the repo, I'm just able to use find in files and quickly find how different CSS properties are structured. And then that helps me inform my design decisions because I can see how things have already been made. And fourthly, related to that, is knowing the fundamentals of how modern development practices work. And by that, I just mean Git. Knowing what Git is, knowing what Git commit, Git pull, Git push, Git merge do. Basically, just Google those words if you've not heard them before. I think that's really important to understand how developers work. And lastly is media queries. This is a bit more web specific, but I think just understanding the fundamentals of how breakpoints work and understanding how you move from a desktop to a tablet to a mobile screen size, that is really important because once you understand that, you'll see that the way elements sit on a page need to flow together so that you're not making new layouts completely for mobile. You're just reflowing what already exists. So I know lots of people watching this will already know all of these things. And in my opinion, that's the answer to should designers know how to code. If you know about those things, about how developers work, then I think you're golden. Anyway, that's all from me for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with a friend and please do like and subscribe below. It really helps me out as I try and create this channel. Anyway, I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.